Hello and welcome to a new episode of Optics Straight Roundtables. As you can see, we are all wearing masks. This is because of the strange year 2020, because of the COVID situation. And Theodore, tell us, how was
2020 in terms of fears and new products?
Yeah.
Well, you probably know, and if you are up to date with everything what is happening in this industry, that only SHOT Show was held this year. Then IWA was first postponed from March to September.
Yeah.
And now we already have the information that even in 2021, the SHOT Show and IWA, they're both cancelled. So hopefully we will see each other with the manufacturers and everybody else in this industry in person in 2022. So this, all of this, what was mentioned, really affected the new product presentations.
Yeah, they were there were really a few novelties presented this year, and those who were online. So
yeah.
No physical introductions of the models. So that was really a new thing in 2020, yeah.
Yeah, I think most manufacturers counted on SHOT Show and IWA 2021 taking place. That's why they were postponing their new releases. And now that they found out that both of these fairs are going to be cancelled, I think that we can expect many online presentations in the beginning of 2021.
I think that some of them already happened, because immediately after the SHOT Show was cancelled, I think Atlan started with presentations of new products.
Yeah, in December, I think that they have on Instagram, they release new information about new products every day.
Yeah, and it was like 2 days after the SHOT Show was cancelled. Yeah. New world, new situation.
Yeah.
Completely.
Okay, so let us take a look at what's new in the field of spotting scopes for 2020. As you can see, we only have two products here on these two tables. And Spela, which product are we going to start with?
With Vortex Diamondback HD. This is the new model in 2020. They are really light and compact, and the housing is
The housing is different from the previous models. I think it's the different shade of green, and there are some features here.
And new materials.
Materials. They are really affordable for this price. They offer quite a lot. I think they're priced at around 400-500 euros. Vortex also claims these are the new generations are optically also better. So
they did a whole refreshment. Yeah.
Yeah.
The housing, optics, everything. A new model.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And what's this big thing there?
It is ridiculously big.
Is the new module by Swarovski, 115 millimeters objective. I have to mention this is only the. Sorry, it's really heavy to hold it with one hand. Thank you. We're talking about the module that is from here to here. So this is only the attachment to the eyepiece. Mm-hmm.
It's the biggest.
This is the biggest objective.
Diameter in the market.
Yeah.
150 millimeter.
It's obviously more brighter, right?
Yeah. It has, I think, 45% more light.
More light gathering.
So
you can watch, you can use my spotting scopes even in dusk or dawn.
Yeah,
I want to point out something here. A few days ago, we installed this spotting scope on a tripod in the morning when it was still dark outside, and we set it at a distance of 300 meters. And when we looked through, we just couldn't believe how bright the image was, even though when you didn't look through the scope just with your eyes, it was dark, and then when you look through, bright. So quite amazing how many light is able to pass through to provide you with a bright image.
Yeah, I missed it because I'm not a morning person.
Of course.
But today came to me from the sales department, and he said, oh, we tested it in the morning, in the dark, the 150 millimeter objective module, and he was completely shocked how bright it is, because honestly speaking, for spotting scopes, low light use is so-so.
Yeah. I think this would look cool with, I mean, the use would be much more comfortable with BTX.
Yeah. It works with 8X, like here.
Yeah.
It works with also STX model, so the straight one, and with the Bino BTX model, yeah.
I think that they are really, this spotting scope is great for digiscoping.
Oh, yeah,
I think that the photography or photos of birding, of birds, would be quite awesome.
Yeah.
Only the one issue here is that it's quite heavy, so taking it to the position where you're planning on installing it might be a little bit tricky because of that.
Well, Masha, you're a photographer.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I don't know, it's big, but I would have to try it.
Oh, speaking about that.
Okay,
we'll take it home. we will send you on a field assignment, and you will test it, and then write a blog about it. My only concern is the weight, because it's so heavy. But on the other side, I haven't tested it yet, but I'm sure that optically it's brilliant.
Optically, it is brilliant, yeah.
So, Masha, you will test it in nature with your cameras.
Okay.
And
then we'll report back.
Yeah. Did you forget anything?
No. Just thank you guys for watching and see you next time.
Bye.